Hey, so the clip you're about to see is taken from a lesson in my advanced framer course. So to provide some context, in the course we built this site, the dtax site, and in the clip you're about to see, we talk about how to make this animated border gradient around the logo wall. Okay, now that's out the way, on with the video. So one thing you might notice in framer is if I select something and I want to add a border to it, there is no option to add a gradient to the border. And that's not a limitation per se of Framer, but that's a limitation in CSS generally. We can't have native gradient borders. But luckily, there's a way we can fake it. And the way we fake it is by having two layers. We have a foreground layer and a background layer. And the background layer has a gradient in it. And all we do is make sure that there's a little bit of padding between the background layer and the foreground layer, and it makes it look like there's a border. In our case, we're going to animate this background gradient by rotating it, and that's going to give the effect of a sort of pulse moving around the border. Okay, so first up, I'm going to show you how to do this without any code components. So I've created a component called test, and inside of test, we have a single variant, and that variant contains a frame that I've pinned to each edge with an offset of 1 pixel, and that gives us this sort of border effect we were talking about. Now the background has a radial gradient on it that's set to the top right corner. But if I lower the opacity of this frame a little bit, you can see what's going on. Okay, so first up, create a new variant and select the background and move the center of this radial gradient to this corner. And then we're going to create a new variant off of that one and do the same. And repeat the process one last time. Okay, so you can imagine what we're going to do here. We're going to set an interaction that happens on appear and transitions to the next variant. Now we can actually use cycle here, which will just trigger all these variants to cycle between each other. So if we hit cycle and then click on the other ones, you'll see that it's all set up to do this loop we want to do. Before we carry on, let's just select all of these variants. We want this transition to take about a second between each one. So now if we preview that, you'll see that nothing really happens. It changes like once and then pauses. And that's because the delay between each one of these transitions is instant. We need to set a delay of a second so that the transition has time to complete. So if we make that one, that should cascade to all the other transitions. Yep. Okay, cool. So now if we preview that, you'll see that it takes a while to get going, but once it's completed a couple of transitions, we get the effect we want. Now, why does it take that pause in the beginning? Well, it's because this first variant is taking a second to even trigger that transition. So there's always going to be a little pause as things appear. So the way to fix that is to use a trick we've used in the past. So we're going to duplicate variant number 4, and we're going to drag it up here, rename it to be idle, and we're going to set this to once, and we're going to make sure it goes to variant 1, and it's going to have no delay on it. It's going to instantly transition, and then we need to go back and change all of these so that they don't cycle, because we want variants 1 through 4 to loop with each other, not include this idle variant. And this is actually why I almost never use the cycle transition. So if we set these up so that they work the way we wanted, and this one loops back to the beginning. Now if we select the idle variant and we start the preview from there, you'll see that we get the perfect transition. There's no immediate delay, but we probably also want to set all of these transitions to be linear, and we also want to set the opacity of this layer back up to 1. So now it's transitioning smoothly between each corner, and this effect is great, but because we only have access to a radial gradient here, we can't really adjust the size of this effect. So I made this code component that allows us to animate a conical variant around the edges of a rectangle. So if we go back to our test component and we actually just delete all the variants except the primary, and let's change the radial background to just a solid one, and we'll make it black. Let's grab our rotating conical gradient and we're just going to drag it in here. We don't want it to be a child of that frame. We want it to be in the main variant. We're going to set it to 100%. Then we want to pin it to 0, so it takes up the full width. And we actually want this frame to be on top of it. Now, if I lower the opacity of this frame so we can see what's going on, and select our rotating conical gradient, you can see we have access to a bunch of properties. So I can adjust things like the distance this is from the edge and the sort of length or width of the gradient itself. So we're going to make it quite wide, and we want to set the color to be sort of white. And maybe let's make the duration like 6 seconds. Let's just grab our frame and turn its opacity back up and preview that. You can see that this looks a lot more like a streak than our radial gradient version did. And that's sort of the effect we're after here. So if we go back and look at the homepage, that's exactly how we have things set up in this logo wall component. We're using Framer's ticket component to cycle through the logos. And then we wrap that in a set of columns that has a rotating conical gradient background. And we just make sure that there's 2 pixels of padding. And the resulting effect is there's just a little streak pulsing around the logo wall. It might be a little bit tricky to see, but we do the same effect on the stat bar. And that's pretty much it for this lesson. Thanks for watching that clip. There'll be a link for this animated gradient border code component somewhere down below. And if you want to sign up for the Framer course, you can go to advancedframer.com. Catch you next time.